Hey lads, it's your Residential Swiss Raptor here, and in today's video we are going to have a look at the new weasels. Because yes, Germany doesn't get one, not two, but three new small light tanks. One being the Weasel 1A4, one being the Weasel 1A2, and the last one being on the Weasel chassis, the Ocelot. Or in German pronunciation, Ocelot. But before we go into each and separate variant, it is important to point out all of those tanks are incredible nimble, incredible fast, four-tracked vehicles and incredible small. And that is why they are called the German cockroaches. So let's commence with the Weasel 1A4. This is your typical light tank with the 20mm Rheinmetall Kanone. And this means that it is a very, very potent gun. It's the same gun we found on the Marder A- and the A1A3. Which is pretty decent. And the most impressive part about the Weasel 1A4 is that it has commander and gunner thermals. With its subcaliber round, which is the same as on the Marder with the DM63, we should also be looking at a pretty decent penetration rate. At the moment, that is 66mm at close range. Depending at what BR that little boy will be, is totally enough to penetrate the side armor of most early MBTs it is going to face, like OF40, like STP1, and so on. So yeah, my prediction will be that this tank will most likely be at around 8.0, pretty similar to the Type 87 RCV, which was much lower before and got up to 8.0, but with less penetration, but thermals, I think that 8.0 or 7.7 might be a pretty decent spot for this lightly tracked tank. Next up, we have the Weasel 1A2, and that thing is a menace. It exchanges the 20mm Rheinmetall Kanone for the TOW 80GM launcher. TOW 2, to be precise, meaning it is able to shoot the TOW 2As, which is a tandem charged 80GM, and the TOW 2Bs, which we are all familiar with being able to shoot at the roofs of enemies. However, this thing only has an ammo capacity of 7 missiles, which is very, very, very little. Yes, it does have thermals, but with only 7 rounds to use, oof, it will be tough to say where this thing should be. However, one of the most important things about this little tank is that it doesn't have an exposed gunner, which makes it miles better than something like the CM11 or the Italian ITO carrier. So, with the fact that it has TOW2Bs, with the fact that it has thermal imaging, I'm pretty confident it is going to get slotted behind the Jagdpanzer K-A2 at around 8.7, maybe even 9.0. And lastly, we have the SPAAG Ocelot, which is on the Weasel 2 chassis, a slightly elongated chassis, and it houses 4 Stinger manpad missiles. Now, that is a problem. At the moment, the Stingers aren't that good, what I've heard from people and from my own experience when I've been using them on the Patton AH-64 attack helicopter. So, it just kind of makes me wonder where Gaijin wants to place the Ocelot. So for example, the Type 93 has decent-ish missiles. Not good, but decent-ish, and it's at 9.7. Is the Ocelot, with worse mobility, better armor protection, and arguably worse missile, going to be also at 9.7? Or is it even going to go down to 9.3, being a Pondo or an equivalent to something like the Sergeant York? While the Sergeant York obviously is going to shred you into pieces with its AGVT rounds, the Ocelot could obviously do that with a direct hit of its fire and forget SAMs. That is, in my opinion, the toughest one. Depending how good the performance of the Stingers really is going to be, this thing could be either at 9.7 or maybe even all the way down to 8.7, which would be incredible potent, especially against the A4 early spam or A4B spam the Americans, which you usually face, are able to muster. It will be pretty interesting to be, however, I think this will be around 9.3. 8.7 just feels too small and too low. 9.0 may be possible, but then again, Germany suffers. So I think 9.3 will most likely be the targeted BR for this little tank. In any case, that is everything I'm having for you today. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to subscribe to be always up to date with everything war fun related. My name is Raging Raptor, and I see you around. Cheers.